still here in Berlin at the Agile Lean European Unconference. And I have a meeting with Olaf Lewitz to talk with him about lean procrastination, what it is and where the value is. Okay, Olaf, thanks for your time for this interview.
Thanks for inviting me.
I was really triggered by your lean procrastination topic. Well, procrastination has a kind of negative term, postponing stuff until it's always too late. But then we came up with lean procrastination. Can you tell me a little bit, what is it?
Yeah, we came up with this idea of when lean teaches us to delay decisions, defer decisions until the last responsible moment, and then there's the bad habit if you do things too late, there might be some sweet spot in between. And through intensive conversations at different conferences, we came up with this idea that if you integrate the network you have into how you organize your work, if you work on something you're really passionate about and you're focused on things that influence each other in the way that think solving one problem might solve half of the next, then interesting things start to happen because you need less management overhead. And I had intensive talks with Chris Matz and Olaf Marson, who have developed this real options thing. And to keep options open until you have better information to make better decisions and to need to spend fewer work on the solving of problems. I think that's an interesting direction to take for your own work organization and maybe even the organization in a company.
So if you would translate it to Scrum terms, it would actually mean normally companies, they put all the stuff on their backlog and people say, oh, put it on the backlog, doesn't
matter. You have to make the decision to put something on
exactly.
the backlog.
Exactly, and if you say, well, postpone the decision to put it on the backlog exactly. until you know for sure that it's supposed to be there, exactly. so why have 1 year on your backlog?
Yeah.
You won't work on it anyway, so postpone the decision to put it on the backlog as well.
So we need to change the thinking from it adds value to a product when you put something into a backlog, because it actually doesn't.
No.
It doesn't change the product at all, but it adds, it diminishes your options what to do in the future.
It's a kind of reminder.
You keep thinking about it, you keep making decisions, do I do it now, do I not do it now. It might keep you from adding another more important thing to the backlog because you think it's so full.
Yeah.
And to just later decide what to do will lead to better products.
So, but if you look to, let's say, larger companies, and we've talked about Enterprise Agile at this conference before, you see companies taking decisions now, which, let's say, they will execute in 6 months, maybe even a year later.
Yeah.
So could we teach lean procrastination to the larger companies? Say, well, just don't worry about it. Don't put it in the planning. Don't put it in the budget. You will know when it's important.
Exactly.
And fix it then.
Yeah. Fix the problems when they are important. Put things in your to-do list, not expect, especially avoiding the word backlog here, when you know best about it, when you have the most information.
Okay.
And that's usually later.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Thanks for your information and thanks for the discussion. You've inspired me to write a column about this.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time.
Yeah, thank you for the interview.
Making money on the stock market is really easy. Just buy your stocks low and sell them high. Everybody knows that. The main problem is, when are they low and when are they high? In Lean, they have something similar. They say, decide at the latest responsible moment. I always ask myself, it sounds nice, but when is it? When is the latest responsible moment? I always know too late that I've missed the best moment to take the decision. Well, today, talking with Olaf about lean procrastination, I learned that if you're in a network, we have enough people around you, things change. You will know when it is important, when people start reminding you. Or when you're in a company, you postpone a decision, you will know when it's there, when customers start asking, the business is asking, so you will know. And we have methods. Look in Scrum, we have a method of sprints of 2 weeks. So why should we put stuff in the backlog for over 6 months if we not sure when we work on it, you know. Putting it on the backlog a few weeks or maybe a few sprints in advance might be good enough. And that triggered me, that if we look to Scrum and how we deal with the backlog, most product owners put everything on the backlog. No, it's there, we think about it, and we'll see it when it's important. But putting it on the backlog is a decision too. which we often don't realize. And if it's too far ahead, we still spend effort on it. We're moving it around, we're thinking about it, we're discussing it with people. So one question remains in my head after talking to Olaf is, what will happen if we use lean procrastination in Scrum and only use a product backlog which looks ahead 4 sprints and not further? Would that improve things? And Frans, have you taped it?
Yeah, really, it's a wrap.
And what do you think about this?
Well, this lean procrastination, I hope my wife doesn't find about it.
Why not?
Well, she has a clean procrastination.
What's that?
She will clean the house at the last responsible moment.
This video blog is sponsored by ProAwareness.